So today I'm going to make a video regarding fairy lights, and one of the most common complications of these fairy lights is that the actual wire that connects the small LEDs is actually quite delicate and it can break sometimes. So if that does happen, what do? You can't directly solder the wires, as I'll show you. You have to do something before that. So that's what today's video is going to be about. I'm going to show you about how you can repair your fairy lights if one of the wires breaks or is cut. Alright, so basically these are the fairy lights, and as you can see, they're working. But what if one of these small wires were to break? Now, basically, at the moment, none of them are broken. All of them are functioning well. But what I will do is I will actually cut one of these small wires so that it does actually stop working. And what I'll do is I'll cut this small wire like this. Now, as you can see, these are not going to work. So what do we do now? Stop it. Stop it. Start. So now, as you can see, these wire ends are cut. You cannot directly solder them because these fairy lights, even though they are made of copper, copper should be brown, right? But since these are silver, that means that these have a small non-conducting material over the wires so that the wires don't short. Because if the material was conductive, wherever the two terminals touched each other or wherever the wires touched each other, they would short at those points. So basically, the entire wire is coated in a non-conductive material so that it does not short. And once these ends are cut, you need to remove a little bit of the non-conducting material so that you can solder the ends together. And an easy way to do that is just with a little bit of sandpaper or emery paper. And all you need to do is just rub around a centimeter of each of the ends of the wire. And as I do it, you'll see that the non-conducting material, which is similar to plastic, like a plastic sheath, comes off. As you can see, this is what I'm talking about. You can see it splitting over here on the background. Over here, you can see these small strands coming out, which is basically the non-conducting material. And that's what we need to remove before we can actually solder the edges. Got the copper.
Start again.
So basically, now I've got the copper, I've got the non-conductive coating off the ends, and you can see that there's a mild color difference. I don't know if it's visible on the phone, but actually there is a brown copper wire that is visible underneath the silver, just at the ends, just for a few centimeters. At the end, I have exposed the copper wire, and now I'm going to just solder these two ends so that it stays permanently, and I can complete the circuit. Two ends of the wire.
Wait, wait, again.
So now I've got the two ends of the wire. I'm just going to turn them on each other, twist them on each other, just so that it makes it a little easier to solder the edges once it's done. And that you don't have to actually solder it after you do this, but I'd prefer to solder it so that it remains permanent. So basically, now the soldering iron is hot enough. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to take a little material off here, a little solder, and I'm just going to make sure that the ends are soldered together. And all I need to do is just apply it over here on the edges, and that should be good enough to hold it. If you try to do this without actually exposing the copper wire, you wouldn't be able to make a connection, and the lights wouldn't turn on. All right, so basically now we have soldered the edges. It's perfectly safe, but it's always a good idea to put on a little insulating tape on the edges, since these are now conducting and these are exposed. Although you can't get a major shock with these fairy lights, since I'm running them through an adapter which is only 5 volts and 2 amperes, even if you do get a shock, it'll be quite minor. But it's always a good idea to seal any open points or any parts of the actual wire that are exposed, and that should be it. And hopefully, if we switch it on, it should work. And there it works. And so, this was just a small 5 to 10 minute video showing you how you can actually repair your fairy lights, and there's no point in actually throwing out the whole strip if you just have one small broken point. And that's all for today. Thanks, guys.